Tiziana here. Welcome to my YouTube channel and welcome to this week's video. Sorry for not uploading that much, but for this week's video, I really wanted to help you guys that are quarantined at home. I'm very lucky because right now I'm not quarantined because I'm in Iceland. If you don't know why I'm here, watch my previous videos. A lot of my friends, a lot of people I know, they are at home, they're struggling. So I tried to make a list of 20 things you can do while quarantined at home, and these are as original as possible. I try not to put the obvious things. Then there are some things that you're probably doing already and that you heard already, but there are some things that are pretty unusual, so stay tuned and let's get into the tips. Everyone is telling you this, so you probably heard it already, working out. But I'm not telling you to do just a random workout. You should do a challenge. There are a lot of Instagram accounts that do workout challenges. Or you could download an app that has a 30-day challenge or something. Some of these Instagram accounts, they have an online community, so you can work out with these other people and do the same exercises, and it can be really fun. It can be something social. Another tip is cooking, but not just cooking. Don't limit yourself to regular cooking. Cook something complicated. Cook some recipes that take a long time or something really difficult to make. Like some Thai cuisine or something like pizza from scratch. It's kind of long to do. It's not like the most complicated thing, but it can be really fun. Another tip is planting seeds and look at them while they're growing into a plant. There are a lot of plants that are very easy to grow, so I would suggest you to do those plants. Another one that's pretty obvious, but is coloring. Painting and drawing, even if you're not good at it, there are a lot of coloring drawings for adults that you can print online, and those are pretty fun. If you're into makeup and beauty, you could do a very weird or extravagant or complicated makeup, and the same for your nails. You could do something crazy, something different. Another one is self-care, face masks, bath bombs, but don't just do it like you would normally do. Take your time and make it a real activity. This one is about social interactions. Watch a movie with a friend that's not physically with you, but you can start the movie at the same time while you're video calling each other, and this way you are like watching the movie together. You can comment the movie and stuff. Another one that's really popular nowadays and that I think can be really beneficial mentally, mostly in this hard period of time, it's meditation. There are lots of cool apps for meditation and YouTube videos, so if you haven't tried it yet, you should definitely do it. Try different hairstyles. Doesn't matter if you're a boy or a girl, and if you have long or short hair, you can always mess up with them, try different things, try different hairstyles. If you don't know how to style them, you could take some time and learn how to make your hair look prettier. You could make a playlist with all your favorite songs based on your mood or based on a certain activity. For example, you could make a workout playlist, or you could make a happy playlist, a sad playlist, and then you can like list the songs on a pastel background or like make it aesthetic, and you can share it on Instagram so your followers can get to know you based on the songs you like, and maybe you'll tell other people about some songs that they don't know. This one is a very obvious one. If you're locked down with your family, take some time to stay with them. Like, a lot of people are doing this, and like, I know, but there are a lot of people that are not doing this enough, so I'm gonna list it anyway. This one is learning a new language. I strongly suggest the app Drops and the app HelloTalk. Drops is for learning vocabulary, while HelloTalk is for meeting new people that are learning your language, but they speak the language you want to learn, so you can have like a cultural exchange. I made a video about this, so if you want to learn a new language while quarantine, check that out. This one is about being creative. You can learn a new choreography, or you can learn the lyrics of a song. Maybe write them down, and maybe you'll notice something that you've never noticed about the song. And dancing can be pretty cool. Just choose a song you like, look up the choreography online, and step by step, try to learn the whole dance. And maybe by the end of the quarantine, you'll find out you're actually pretty good at dancing. I think it's really important when you're always at home to make a schedule of the things you want to do in a day. So take some time, make a list of the things you want to do, place them in a specific order with a specific time for doing each thing, and try to stick to it as much as possible. Another one for those of you who are into photography, take some aesthetic, cool pictures at home. You can play with the lighting, you can play with the different objects you have around the house, so don't think you have to go that far to take good pictures, because you can take amazing shots even in your house. During this time, I see a lot of people that they don't know what to watch on Netflix, they don't know what to watch on YouTube. My personal tip, if you're really out of shows to watch, rewatch your favorite cartoon as a child. A lot of people are doing this, so I don't think it's a very original tip, but dye your hair different color or cut your hair. It's gonna be fun. They're going to regrow back for the end of the quarantine, so you're fine. Just do whatever you want with it. You could download the app Wattpad and look for stories to read that are completely free. And if you're into writing, consider writing your own story. Maybe you could write a short story. You don't have to write a whole book, you can even write a short story. If you live in a place where there's sun outside and it's getting warmer in spring, consider sitting on your balcony or outside in your garden, if you have a garden, and listen to some music. But put your phone on airplane mode, don't post anything on Instagram, on Facebook, whatever, just listen to music and get some sunlight in, and I promise you, you're gonna feel way better. The last one is to try on some outfits. Probably being in quarantine, you're always at home wearing your pajama, that may affect your mental health somehow, so try some cool outfits, or maybe like plan an event you want to go to as soon as the quarantine will be over, and try to pick the perfect outfit for that. Maybe you could even try to recreate some TV show characters' outfit. So that was it for this week's video. I hope my tips helped you to go through this quarantine. I am so sorry for everyone that is quarantined at home in this moment. I am very lucky for the freedom I have, and I'm really sorry for my country, Italy, that is going through such a hard time, and that's why I made this video. I wanted to share these tips with you guys and hopefully help someone that is really bored and sad right now. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you don't want to get bored in quarantine, subscribe to my channel, because I'm gonna make more videos and you can see what I'm doing here. I'm gonna leave the link to my Instagram in the description if you wanna check the pictures I take here in Iceland. It's a bad time, but it's not gonna be forever, so let's do what's best to keep us all safe and just hang in there. See you in the next video. Bye!